Okay, now after Arrhenius, the next scientist who gave us definitions for acids and bases, they were Bronsted and Lowry, and therefore the concept is known as Bronsted-Lowry concept or Bronsted-Lowry theory for acids and bases. According to this theory, definition for acid, it is a substance that donates a proton. It is a substance that donates a proton. Proton means H plus ions. That means the substance which can donate H plus ions in aqueous medium, they are known as acid according to Bronsted and Lowry concept. So according to Bronsted-Lowry concept, what is definition of base? A substance that accepts a proton. Again here, proton means H plus ions. A substance which can accept proton is known as a base. In short, we can say that proton donors are, Bronsted acids. Proton donors are Bronsted acids, while proton acceptors are Bronsted bases. As the whole theory is based on only proton, proton donors are acids while proton acceptors are bases. As the whole theory based on only protons, therefore this theory is also known as Bronsted-Lowry proton transfer theory or Bronsted-Lowry proton transfer concept. Now, next article, next sub point in this conjugate acid base pair. Let us consider one reaction, HCl hydrochloric acid plus ammonia NH3. At equilibrium gives formation of NH4 plus ammonium ion plus Cl minus chloride ion. Now all of you know HCl is a strong acid. Therefore, I have written here acid. Now, what is the difference in between reactant and product sides? Let us study. HCl is converted into Cl minus. HCl is converted into Cl minus by loss of proton. HCl is converted into Cl minus by loss of proton. When we remove H plus from HCl, it will get converted into Cl minus. That means proton is donated and proton donors are acids according to Bronsted concept. Therefore here acid. Secondly, NH3, ammonia. Ammonia changes to NH4 plus. Ammonia changes to NH4 plus. Reactant side ammonia, when accept one proton, then get converted to NH4 plus ion to the product side. Again, proton acceptors are bases, therefore ammonia is a base. Why these 1, 2, 1, 2 are here? As HCl and Cl minus differ only by single proton, similarly NH3 and NH4 plus differ only by a single proton, such a pair of acid and base, which differ by a single proton is known as conjugate acid base pair. What is meaning of this word conjugate? Differ by single proton. Conjugate acid base pair is a pair of acid and base which differ by single proton. So they have only difference of one proton in between them. You can recheck from product side to reactant side. NH4 plus converted to NH3 with loss of one proton and proton donors are acids. Therefore, this one is acid. Okay. Cl minus converted into HCl with gain of one proton. Therefore, Cl minus proton gain means proton acceptors are bases according to Bronsted concept. Hence, Bronsted and Lowry concept or theory can very well explain conjugate acid base pair and is the example in front of you. So you may write down this one is a HCl and Cl minus is a conjugate acid base pair. One, and ammonia and NH4 plus is a conjugate acid base pair. Number two, क्वेश्चन में भी आस्क्ड फॉर एमसीक्यू एमसीक्यू मध्ये क्वेश्चन येऊ शकतो आउट ऑफ द फॉलोइंग व्हिच वन इज कॉन्जुगेट एसिड बेस पेयर आउट ऑफ द फॉलोइंग व्हिच वन इज कॉन्जुगेट व्हिच वन इज नॉट अ कॉन्जुगेट एसिड बेस पेयर और एनी वन ऑफ द स्पेसिस इज गिवन सपोज NH3 इज गिवन एंड राइट द कॉन्जुगेट एसिड ऑफ NH3 और राइट द कॉन्जुगेट एसिड ऑफ Cl- और राइट द कॉन्जुगेट बेस ऑफ NH4+ और राइट द कॉन्जुगेट बेस ऑफ HCl और एनी अदर एग्जाम्पल्स मे बी ओके इन दिस वे कॉन्जुगेट एसिड बेस पेयर अगेन द टू ड्रॉबैक्स विच वी स्टडीड ऑलरेडी इन Arrhenius कंसेप्ट that some of the compounds they do not contain hydrogen atom so they don't have tendency to donate proton but still they are acidic nature of such substances was not explained by Bronsted and Lowry similarly proton acceptors some substances may be present which don't have tendency and then this theory instead of studying will study the next theory third concept or third theory for acids and bases given by scientist Lewis and therefore it is known as Lewis concept you may pronounce it as Lewis concept or Lewis concept okay Lewis concept or Lewis theory according to this theory an acid is any species that can accept electron or an acid is any species that can gain electron and a base is any species that can donate electron So what is the difference between Bronsted-Lowry and Lewis theory? Bronsted-Lowry is a protonic theory based on proton, while Lewis theory is an electronic theory based on electron. Electron acceptors are acids. Electron donors are bases. Electron acceptors are acids and electron donors are bases. Okay, in this way, you may apply these definitions for electrophile and nucleophile. Okay, for example, electrophile. What do you mean by electrophile? Electro, electron, philos, loving, electron loving. Electron loving means they are electron deficient. They are electron deficient. They loves electron means they accept electron so electron acceptors are acids according to Lewis concept in this way okay now let us study one example for Lewis theory ammonia NH3 ammonia all of you know nitrogen carries a lone pair of electron on it now in both way we can explain this reaction proton get attracted towards this nitrogen or lone pair of electron get donated by ammonia I will repeat again any species that can accept electron so any species which donate electron is a base therefore ammonia is a base according to Lewis concept as it contain lone pair of electron which is donated to proton and therefore we get formation of a directional coordinate bond here yellow color okay coordination compound is always written in square bracket you already studied this then in second manner how we can explain acidic nature of H+ ion any species that can accept electron H+ ion is going to accept this electron pair therefore H+ ion is acid in this case according to Lewis concept again a second example BF3 boron trifluoride BF3 electron deficient species and NH3 electron rich species Electron deficient species have tendency to accept electron and electron acceptors are acids okay and electron rich species have tendency to donate electron electron donors are bases according to Lewis theory therefore again ammonia is a base no doubt while BF3 is an acid now here you can conclude the acidic nature of BF3 the acidic nature of BF3 can only explained by Lewis theory and not by Arrhenius theory or by Bronsted and Lowry theory therefore Lewis theory is one of the best advanced theory to judge or to classify the given compounds as acid or bases. Very simple concept. Electronic theory. Electron acceptors are acids and electron donors are bases. Okay. After that, we have to let us complete this example. Here is formation of coordinate bond between nitrogen and boron. Direction of coordinate bond is as like tail of the arrow is towards donor atom and head of the arrow is towards acceptor atom. Here also, tail of the arrow towards donor atom and head of the arrow towards acceptor atom. If any charge present on this, then charge goes to complex. Here it is no any charge, therefore complex is neutral. In this way, the examples for Lewis theory. Now, very important concept. Might be you studied some of the part in the 11th standard also, and the concept is known as amphoteric nature of water. Question may be asked for CET. Water is, and options may be given like acidic, basic, amphoteric, or can't say. So, amphoteric nature of water. Water is always amphoteric in nature. What do you mean by amphoteric? To study this, let us consider two reactions. First reaction, let we have HCl in aqueous medium plus water in liquid state at equilibrium gives formation of what we can get formation of? Yes, water plus HCl. What we can form? H2O is a liquid, HCl, HCl get dissociate into H2O, H plus plus Cl minus, and formation of the respective oppositely charged ions H3O plus and Cl minus. So at equilibrium we get formation of H3O plus in the aqueous medium plus Cl minus in the aqueous medium. Reaction is very simple. But we have to explain amphoteric nature of water. For this, let us consider second reaction also. And the second reaction is, suppose NH3, ammonia in aqueous medium plus water in liquid state at equilibrium, it gives formation of ammonia except one proton and we get formation of NH4 plus aqueous plus OH minus aqueous. Now what we have to conclude? According to the protonic theory, what happened here? HCl donates one proton and proton donors are? Yes, proton donors are acids or bases. Proton donors are acids. Therefore, HCl is an acid. Water get converted into H3O plus, water converted to hydronium ion by acception of one proton, by gain of one proton, and proton acceptors are bases according to Lowry and Bronsted concept. Similarly, ammonia NH3 accepts one proton to get converted into NH4 plus ion, and proton acceptors are bases according to Lowry-Bronsted concept. Therefore, ammonia is a base. Now, in this case, H2O, it loses one proton, donates proton to convert into OH minus ion. Therefore, it is acidic according to Bronsted and Lowry concept. Now, if you observe carefully, in the first reaction, when water is allowed to react with strong acid, it behaves like a base, and in the second reaction, when water is allowed to react with strong base, it behaves like acid according to Bronsted Lowry concept. This means that water has tendency to act or to behave as like acid and base. Water can show both properties of acid and base respectively on reacting with strong base or acid, and this nature of water is known as amphoteric nature of water. What do you mean by amphoteric? Water is a substance which whenever reacted with strong acid act like base, and whenever reacted with strong base behaves like acid. Such a tendency of substance to act or to behave both like acid as well as base, or to show properties of both acid as well as base, is known as amphoteric nature of water.